enter in quiet mode.
Hey, that's against regulation.
Sorry.
What do you think you're doing?
I was just leaving.
Just keep your fingers to your own self, okay?
I guess caught sooner or later. Left field toss ball betting. And we've got whatever's up there. Maybe someone won't see us here. Just have to be out of sight, that's all. And geez. He'd probably even come after us for things we steal next to the trash. Let's check out left field toss ball. Penny.
We don't get many outsiders. You don't look like Sublight. Must be freelance.
Into Cleo's darlings. Hi.
Ooh, you're the new face. Wow, you must be up on all the latest tossball games.
Not at all.
So who do you follow? Wait, don't tell me. You look like a Hammersmith Thunder fan. No, Glacial Age Mammoths.
I play for Auntie Cleo's Darlings. Don't you recognize me?
I'd heard they'd gotten a new hacker. Is that why everyone's making such a fuss about you? But what are you doing on Monarch?
This is all part of our goodwill tour of, goodwill, not goodwill. Or farewell, no. Goodwill tour of Halcyon. We're meeting our fans across the colony.
Maybe we're not so isolated as I thought. So, what can I do for you?
You said you were having trouble receiving the tossball game transmissions, did you?
Graham's always filling the airwaves with this propaganda. Like it's done him any good. All it means is the tossball games get to us in fragments. Makes them real hard to watch.
Well, that's it for now, then. Don't mind my friend here. So what's up these stairs? What's the main building, actually? Unknown. Hi.
Watch your step if you venture outside the walls.
Thanks.
You don't look like Sublight. Must be freelance.
Abigail Edwards. Hello there.
Hello, dearie. Why, I don't believe I've seen you before.
Dearie?
And with sweet cheeks like those, I'd remember.
Sweet cheeks?
What can Auntie Abigail do for you?
Oh, I don't have the medical for that. Oh. Oh, this is a dispensary. Are you in charge of handing out medicine?
Yes, indeed. Someone's got to keep Stellar Bay's people healthy and energized.
You certainly seem excited about your job.
Oh, but I am. I get to see plenty of my neighbors here, and I do dearly love a little gossip.
I've been asked to pick up some medicine, some kind of caffeine or steroids. I know it's Caffenoid, but I can't tell you. I guess it's on the tip of my tongue.
Bless your little heart. You must mean Caffenoid.
What do we have for Johnny?
One pill does the deed.
Okay.
Now, dearie, who's this pickup for?
That's private.
Now, there's no keeping secrets from Auntie Abigail. I'll tease it out of you one way or another.
You will?
Also, I really do have to enter someone's name for the allotment. After all, I have to keep track of where our little pills wander off to.
$2,700? You're rather nosy, aren't you?
Now, dearie, it is my job, after all.
I don't know, Auntie. You'll have to pry that secret right from my sweet little cheeks.
Aren't you a saucy thing?
Ain't I ever.
I may not be a fresh young thing anymore, but with age comes experience, dearie.
So why don't you show me a thing or two? Calling her bluff.
Much as I'd love to, my rheumatism is especially fierce at the moment, and I'm all out of my medicine.
You gotta be kidding.
But I'd hate to send you away empty-handed. You were here for Caffenoid, weren't you? Who's it for?
Would that reflect bad on Nyoka if I... Oh, the pills are for me.
I'm so sorry, but with the iconoclasts and the marauder filth chasing away what little trade we get, I'm afraid I have to reserve my supply for Stellar Bay residents.
Oh, wait, no.
Our reserves have gotten so low, I've even had to start locking the supply room upstairs. Isn't it a shame what some people will do to get a little extra?
Supply room upstairs. Yeah, you just can't trust people these days.
Except for you. I can tell. You've got one of those faces.
I do?
I'd make an exception for you if I could, my little cherub. Is there anyone else needing a special pickup from Auntie Abigail?
Yeah, Nyoka.
Oh, her.
Oops.
It's none of my business, but I have told her Dr. Williams would bump up her monthly allotment
right.
If only she'd join MSI. Contribute, like the rest of us.
They won't give her any right now.
No, I've gone and said too much. And you know me, dearie. I don't like to pry.
There must be some way I can increase Nyoka's allotment.
I'm afraid not. Dr. Williams managed the town's allotments from his terminal upstairs. Even I can't access them.
Thought you were in charge around here, Auntie. Sure ought to be.
Oh, you flatter an old woman. Me, I'm just here to be a pretty face for the customers. And to keep an extra key to the supply room for all the times Dr. Williams misplaced his.
Remind me, what supply room again?
The one upstairs, where we store our medicines.
Where can I find this Dr. Williams?
In the town graveyard, I'm afraid.
Oops.
Poor man was always searching for the Flower of Enlightenment. On the way, he tried some rather daring substance combinations.
The Flower of Enlightenment?
It's a philosophist's symbol of some kind, dearie. Never you mind.
Okay.
The graveyard's near the southern ruins. You're certainly welcome to pay our respects, but the bodies tend to attract beasties.
I can imagine.
Do be careful. I'd hate for anything to happen to you, dearie.
I see no reason to intimidate her. Plus, I'm not sure if this means that I don't have a good chance of it. She's really nice. I don't see a reason to like, nasty with her. We'll go upstairs and pick the lock ourselves. I guess I'll have to figure this out on my own.
Chin up, dearie.
About my cheeks, now my chin. Any interesting things to look at in here? That I'm allowed to look at? Okay. You just stay right there. Create a new account. Well, let's hack. E. Williams. Okay, patient records. Please enter the name Nyoka. Caffenoid allotment standard. Medical engineer notes. Liver damage likely the result of prolonged alcoholism. Attitude problems likely the result of prolonged alcoholism and frequent social withdrawal. Same. Should I increase the allotment? Allotment increased too high. Warning, excessive caffeinoid consumption may lead to side effects such as... Oh, I hope she's going to be alright. Irritability, fatigue, uncontrollable bowel movements, nausea, and death. Warning, caffeinoid storage is approaching critical levels. Resupply recommended. I'm not sure if I should have done that. I'll be helping her kill herself. Oh, myself, Alicia Clark. Patient not found. Please try again. Oh, I figured they had a record on me. Data storage. E. Williams. Notes from experiments as conducted by Dr. E. Williams. Reacticism plus pep you up. I had hypothesized that this combination might awaken my mind and senses to the greater realities around us. If that is true, then it seems my faculties were quite overwhelmed in this instance. Shortly after the dosage, I experienced cold sweats, tremors, and mild paranoia. It is perhaps due to these latter effects that most of my notes from the episode are of little use. Nevertheless, the effects were most invigorating. I will have to attempt a milder dosage once heart palpitations subside. Bushberry extract plus debilaryl. After my previous experiments, I theorized that deadening the external senses might allow the mind's eye to glimpse the eternal. Alas, I was only partially successful. The combination of substances quickly rendered me both blind and feeble, so much so that I soon fell into a stupor. I awoke some hours later in a pile of my own sick and a most curious craving for Tilleritos. Costolarine plus a triple dosage. File empty. Alright. Deleted. A. Edwards. Someone, you're writing a novel. She's a stellar bride. She's a wide-eyed colonist from Earth. He's a hard-working Saltuna farmer from Monarch. Their attraction blossoms into a worldwide romance that transforms Stellar Bay. Chapter 3. A Long Way from Arkansas. You can put your things here, Mr. Elliot said, leading Abby into a dim apartment. The place was small, but it had a certain cozy charm. Abby set her bags on the floor and loosened the straps of her jumpsuit. Mr. Elliot coughed, his face suddenly red. If you get warm, you can always crack the window. Breeze from the bay is real nice. Just be careful about mantis swarms. As Abby went to take the room key, her fingers brushed his. He had strong, rough hands. A Saltuna farmer's hands. She felt herself blush. You've been ever so kind to me, Mr. Elliot. Call me Archibald, he said. Okay, work in progress number 2. Oh, these are separate ones? The Passion Broker. A renegade iconoclast, driven by his ideals, finds love in the arms of a mysterious man with a tortured past. Will he follow his head or his heart? Chapter 2. Tall, dark, and handsome. Come on up, said the voice on the comm. It was dangerous and smooth in a way that reminded Broderick of iceberg-aged whiskey. The door slid open with a whisper of perfumed air. The hair rose along the nape of his neck, and he proceeded up the stairs. The broker sat with his back to a top-of-the-line, mostly charcoal personal heater, slender fingers tented. So this was the mysterious recluse who manipulated Monarch from afar. Broderick could feel the warmth of the heater from across the room, but it was the look in the broker's eyes that had him feeling feverish. The broker produced a pair of glasses and a bottle of something that looked expensive. He poured it off and held one of the glasses out to Broderick. "For me?" he asked, trying to ignore the man's smoldering gaze. "Indeed," the broker purred. "I know you're a man of bold tastes. Broderick took the glass. The broker continued, dark hair falling over darker eyes. "That's why I've got a rare proposition for you." The glass nearly slipped from Broderick's fingers. He drank it in one gulp to hide the tremor in his hand. It burned all the way down. I don't know why. It reminds me of Skyrim, those books that are a play. Oh god, I can't remember the name now. The one with lifts her tail. I can't remember the name. Okay. Clinic of the Heart. A battle-hardened young Earth Directorate soldier visits a remote clinic on Monarch to heal his injuries. But when he meets Gale, an elegant older nurse, she goes to work on his heart as well. Chapter 34, Healing Touch. Is there more written, or is this just like we're sampling the stuff because we don't want to read all this? Or is it just this starting with chapter 34? Fletcher held her tightly. His strength had returned. That much was clear. Yet here he remained, at the clinic, with her. He shook his head as if he'd read her mind with his perfect green eyes. Gale. He shook his head as if he'd read her mind with his perfect green eyes. Gail, the Earth Directorate's calling me back. They want me protecting Byzantium, but I don't know how to leave. Not after what we've found together. Then stay, she whispered, letting her breath warm his ear. I can certainly find a proposition for you here. Oh, laws, he moaned, pulling her closer. She pressed a finger to his lips. Shh, the only law here is love. So bad. That's Parvati, okay. So making sure she's not running up. Oh, that's the stairs that we saw from outside. Okay, so now... time to get your stuff. And other things. Got it. Search Dr. Williams' body. I mean, I guess I can do that. A. Williams. So wait a second. Account setup requires a persistent connection to the central communications tower. Connection offline. So E. Williams. A. Edwards. So who's Edwards? Dr. Williams, who used to be in charge of Stellar Bay's medical allotment, is buried in a graveyard in the ruins south of town. Abigail implied that both she and Dr. Williams both have keys to the medical supply room. I have Nyoka's pill. According to Abigail, Dr. Williams manages allotments from a terminal upstairs. Sounds like Abigail stores medications in a locked supply room upstairs. Abigail implied that she and Dr. Williams both have keys. You've bumped Nyoka's allotment up. Abigail can get you an extra dose of Caffenoid now. Oh, we stole it as well. Alright. So she can get me even more now. So Abigail Edwards. Who's the guy in the Williams? Williams is the one. Okay. I hate the way they just put the first initial. So he's the one with all the... he's the unpublished novelist, I guess. And she's the one with the research, so... I figured I could ask her. I figured she wrote that stuff, but no, he did.
Come to share a secret with Auntie Abigail?
Oh. I guess she's not going to give me more caffeinoid after all. Alright. Alright, so that's what was back here. What's this? Empty room? Empty building? Well, don't mind if I do then. Constable. Can't go into the constable. We can go up top, though. Sure, let's go out and see what's up there. Gonna use those jets now. Don't be alarmed. It's pretty awesome though. I was gonna say, is there any reason to go up here? And I guess is that we can't get past there otherwise. Okay. So it's a secret area. Cool. Hope nothing tries to kill me in here. Yeah, because that's blocking. Oh, we got plasma carbine. I might have found this once before, a plasma carbine. Has everything a good range, decent damage, even splash damage on nearby targets, plus its overcharge feature will get you out of a tight spot every time. Okay. Hidden area. Tempted to jump, but that'll hurt me. High enough to even kill me. So never mind. Where is he? Oh, okay. Hello. Thank you very much.
Got any news from the rest of Halcyon?
Well, we don't get many outsiders.
Okay. Pull his string.
Got any news from the rest of Halcyon?
You need more things to say. That's... we just visited her. Is it here that I haven't been?
Got any news from the rest of Halcyon?
Absolutely not.
We don't get many outsiders.
Place has seen better days, probably.
Watch your step if you venture outside the walls.
Oh, I will eventually.
Fresh blood at last. Stellar Bay could use some. We're not the best equipped, but scouting for rats keeps us on our toes.
I'd love to get in there, but you guys will attack me. At the very least, I'll have to give you a lot of money or try to persuade skill on you. I haven't been in here, have I? Oh. I was about...
Someone's been killed!
What? Who's been killed?
I think I'm gonna be sick.
Pull yourself together and tell me what happened.
I cleaned the apartments while everyone's at work. I've seen all sorts of messes, but this... If you're going into the apartments, do not go into the lower one on the right. That's where the body is.
That's where I'm going.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to go contemplate a hot shower.
Lower on the right, huh?
The body's in the first apartment on the right. So much blood.
Sebastian's over there. What do you think about all this?
Watch your step if you venture outside the walls.
You need to watch my step in here as well. Apartments? Vending machine.
Oh! Oh, sorry, sorry. Just spooked me, was all.
Body bag dispenser empty. Please replace sack reel before disposing of any corpses.
Sack reel. You know how many marauders and outlaws we've killed? Don't be kidding me, Parvati. Well, doesn't have anything on him. Yep, completely covered with blood.
Got it. Heads down.
I don't think he's gonna be needing any of this stuff. Magnum. No sign of the killer. You've got a mystery afoot. Ah! Hastily packed suitcase. Several ragged outfits, all of the same cut and color, were stuffed into this suitcase. Interesting. Stainless steel rat. That's a set of novels. Tossball betting slip. This betting slip lists some increasingly bold wagers made for a team called Mostly Colonists. It's from left field tossball betting. Oh, we can head back there to get a lead. Let's stop sneaking and see if we can find anything else. Oh. Just trying to steal some money. These papers, nothing. That's certainly interesting. Had no idea we'd be picking up so many new quests. A man has been killed in a Cellar Bay apartment. It falls to you to figure out what happened to him. It's not clear what happened to the victim, but something in the apartment might point you in the right direction. You found a betting slip from left field tossball betting. There's a suitcase full of clothes by the door. The victim had a betting slip from left field. Yeah, perhaps someone there knows what happened to him. Sweet. I like this. It's a mystery. Hold on 1 second, guys. I need to get another drink. Okay, so two things. What I was trying to remember before was the books Volume 1 and 2 in Skyrim, The Lusty Argonian Maid, which is what Dr. Williams attempts. We found on that terminal his attempts at writing romance novels. So that's what that reminded me of. If I can remember, I'll put it, little subtitle there on the video. If not, well then here. This is your notification. It's probably in another episode anyway, people telling me what it is. I know, but think there's a third thing, you know. I just think there's a third thing. I don't know why. And the Stainless Steel Rat is a series of science fiction books, a science fiction comedy by Harry Harrison, if I have that right. He's an anti-hero who's a con man, bank robbers, you know, etc. Very charismatic. And, yeah. Funny as well. Alright, so that goes outside, and we've got this. Oh, there's somebody in here. Hello. I was about to steal your stuff.
You don't look like Sublight. Must be freelance.
Thanks. Can I look at this? These people don't seem to mind us looking at terminals. 2. S. Nandy. Mr. Nandy, sorry to bother you about this, but something foul is leaking from the apartment upstairs. I don't know what Celia's keeping up there, but she works for you, right? Do you think you could talk to her about it? 2. Isaac Rose. Can you please try to keep your windows shut? As I've tried to explain, leaving them open, especially when you've got food out, invites mantis swarms, and a mantis swarm infestation is everyone's problem. I'm not looking forward to finding these mantis swarms. To be hecked, Braxton, yeah. I know you keep odd hours. I know, because I've heard you coming and going at all times of the day, night, haha. But maybe you could try to close your door a little more quietly. I have rather sensitive nerves, and every time I hear your door, I think we're in the middle of another Amber Heights. Oh, that's funny. I want that stuff. I don't know if it's going to work with her back turned or not. I'm not sure how it all works. So we've got two stairs which just lead to the same landing up here.
Whatever you do, don't mention Tossball to Isaac. You'll never hear the end of it.
You know, I haven't seen him in a while.
If you'd gotten stuck in an hour-long rant about mostly colonists, you'd be thankful.
Carry on.
Hmm? Anyone home? Nothing here but us goody chests? Okay. That's a sad bed, huh? Well, look, we got one of these Reaper Scythe things. Inferno Scythe. What we got here? Is this Parcheesi? Kind of looks similar. What you got? Breaking that down. Alright. There's two beds in here. Whoever sleeps in here isn't gonna be too pleased when they return. Oh well. You can tell I'm all broken up about it. Laura, hi.
You startled me. Don't sneak up on a person like that, huh?